So we're going to talk about continuing on with unemployment. We're going to talk about the magnitude or the extent of unemployment here in India. So what is unemployment? It is said that if a person is said to be unemployed when he's able and willing to work but does not find work. That is all the people within the range of 15 to 60 years of age. Economists have defined an unemployed person as one who's not able to get employment even for 1 hour and half a day. So 1 day equals to 8 man hours. And it is a national sample survey that defines unemployment as a situation and though as those who are able to work and they lack work and they're not working, but they're seeking work. Through what? Through employment exchanges, intermediaries, friends, relatives. So that means they are unemployed. Under whatever the prevailing conditions, they're looking for a job. So just go through this. So what is basically the magnitude is very difficult to say. So a person is said to be unemployed when he's able and willing to work at the prevailing wage rate but does not find work. So that is unemployment problem. That is the magnitude. If there are certain people who are voluntarily unemployed, that is, they prefer to remain out of work at prevailing wage rate, so then they will not be treated as unemployed. So it is equally important, along with willingness and the ability to work, that a person should not be voluntarily unemployed at the given wage rate. And suppose if a person is willing to work but due to some physical disablement cannot find work, he will also not be counted as unemployed. So according to this, so when we are talking about unemployed people, they refer to those in the age group of 15 to 60 years, children below 15 years of age, and old people beyond 60 are not considered while counting the number of unemployed. So these people do not become a part of the labor force. So they are not a part of the labor force, even when they are able and willing to work. So thus, what is unemployment? That it is, it refers to a kind of situation where people have ability and are willing to work at the existing wage rate, but they do not get remunerative full-time job. So then we have the National Sample Survey, who says that they are seeking for some employment. They are looking for employment. Only then will you be called unemployed. So that is NSSO. So NSSO defines or talks about three broad activity status. First is working, that is engaged in an economic activity, that is employed. Second is seeking or available for work, that is unemployment, employed. And third is neither seeking nor available for work. So these are the status that they have, activity status. So you're talking about the usual status they talk about, that is, the usual status concept is meant to determine the usual activity status, that is employed or unemployed or outside the labor force, for those who are covered by the survey. The activity status is determined with reference to a year preceding to the time of survey. All those persons who are found usually unemployed in a year preceding to the time of survey are counted as unemployed. The usual status unemployed rate indicates long-term unemployment because all those who are found usually unemployed in the reference year are counted as unemployed. So generally we talk about the usual status, and the activity status is working, second is seeking work, and third is unemployed. So all those individuals having a broad activity status of, say, working or seeking work, are classified as being in the labor force, and those who are having activity status, that is neither seeking nor available for work, are classified as outside the labor force. Thus, labor force constitutes of both employed and unemployed. And based on that, we find that the unemployment rate has been quite a bit. It's say up to 6.9% in 2018. And if according to this, you see the number of unemployed in millions, it's in 2018, it was 29.5 million. So the high rate of unemployment were noticed in those states where the ratio of agricultural workers to cultivators was high. Second, the pressure of population on land was very high. Third, the rate of urbanization was relatively higher, while the level of industrial development was lower. The rate of labor force participation among women was high. And fifth, there was widespread education, high school and university education. So basically, this is how we are talking about the extent of, there is a very high magnitude of unemployment in India.